If you want to learn how to speak English the way I do, but your English is not even half as good as the way that you speak Hindi or your mother tongue, then this is a video for you. I am talking to someone who can read and write and speak a very basic level of English. In today's world, whether you think it is right or not, English is important. There are lots of people who are very successful without having a solid command over the language. And please do not think that I am even trying to suggest that you need to speak in English to be happy, or in fact to be intellectual and smart. I'm not asking people to learn English. In fact, people are constantly asking me how I speak English the way I do. And because of all of these comments that I have been receiving, I decided to make this video. The first thing I realized that most videos will give you this tip. Watch 4 to 5 YouTube videos and at least a few shows on OTT platforms. But if you think that in 6 months your English will be some kind of international standard, then sorry boss, nahi hota aise.
Hayar,
hayar,
is my
money,
bitch.
It takes a child 5 to 6 years to understand every ad on TV word for word and to speak their mother tongue in this grammatically correct and well-versed manner. Added to this is the fact that English grammar, it's very different from most languages around the planet. Hindi, in fact, is closer to Japanese than English. So for example, here is a sentence in English, but this is how we would say it in Hindi and Japanese. From Japan to India, it takes 10 hours by flight. Japan se Bharat tak udaan mein 10 ghante lagte hain. Nihon kara indomade hikoki daju jikan kakari mas. As another example, selling her wares. Where is she? She wears it. She will wear it out. The challenge is thoda to tough. So believe me that only watching videos on YouTube, it's not going to really take you where you want to go. You're going to have to attack it from multiple directions all of the time. And if you are looking for shortcuts, then sorry, I don't have them. But what I do have is my own research, plus my own experience, plus the fact that in my heart of hearts, I really do want to help. And I am going to try and take this subject and make a habit out of it. Depending on your comments and your reactions, then I will give you more. So ask me questions and tell me what it is that you want. My name is Freesia, this is WAC, and together we are going to get better at speaking English properly and confidently. I have in the description below linked 4 great videos by other Indian YouTubers on the same subject, and I recommend that you watch them all. They will tell you stuff like there is no replacement for reading. And if you do try to build a house without a knowledge of plumbing and architecture and design, then the most that you're going to get is a basic jhopadi. Sure, it will protect you from the harsh sun rays, but you will never know what the view from the 21st floor looks like. For that, you need a solid base to build on. So if you attempt to master English without understanding the basic grammar, plumbing, or its poetry, design and architecture, then you will never be able to see it from this vantage point. The truth is that when it comes to languages, the later that you start, the tougher it gets. The older you are, the more hard work you will have to put in. If our brain is used to computing in a certain language, then new codes, they can confuse it. Our bodies and brains are just designed that way. I'm not trying to discourage you. I just want you to have this realistic understanding. I was born in an English-speaking house, raised in an English-speaking environment. I did theatre at a very young age in English, and I finally graduated in English literature. If I tried to learn your mother tongue and become as good as you, it would take me at least 5 years. So please be patient with your growth. Don't be hard on yourself. In 3 to 4 years of regular work, I promise you, you will look back at how far you have come with immense pride. Now I want you to imagine a skinny kid walking into a gym and trying to bench press 70 kilos. Nahi hone wala hai. Common sense says that he will have to start with basic pull-ups, building his way then to 5 to 10 kilo dumbbells, and then one day he will actually surprise himself more than anyone else with his own strength. Exercising mental muscles is exactly the same. Don't attempt to lift more than you can and then get discouraged. You know, I love using big words, and the truth is that more often than not, I am wrong. My family loves catching my mistakes and making fun of me. But I'm okay with that because the people that I love are laughing at me, and I'm also getting to learn something new. Humility is something that a student needs to have. So here's a formula. KISS. Keep it simple and sweet. If you're worried about other people laughing at you while you are learning and growing, then please remember that you're not here to worry about what other people think. Most of these people, they might not even be in your life 2 to 3 years down the line. And the fear of what they think, that should not stop you from growing. And when you experiment with a new word and someone corrects you, even if they laugh, you can just take it in a sweet and simple way. You're not competing with anyone except for who you used to be. If you are a better speaker than what you were yesterday, then that is growth. And I think that is enough. Now I'm going to give you 5 personal tips, and I would like you to make them your homework and that you continue doing so for as long as possible. There is a reason that we teach children nursery rhymes that are set to music. It's an easier way for our brains to retain it. Rhyming words set to music, they're much simpler than some random para. So why don't you do the same with English songs? Start listening to them, read the lyrics, and then sing along. This is the kind of practice that will allow you to be more confident and at ease while speaking. To up your game, join an English theatre group. This is a sure shot way to take your English speaking skills to the next level. Now, I'm not saying that go and act on stage. Go work backstage, in costume, production, anything. Just being around people who are speaking in English all the time, it will definitely help you. Force your brain to code in a new language. When I'm trying to improve my Hindi, I speak to myself in Hindi all the time. Again, at home, they make a lot of fun of me. But the only reason I am telling you this is that it will become a great way and this wonderful technique to practice speaking in Hindi or English, whatever it is that you want. Whatever your thoughts are, whatever they are, translate them into English, and then when possible, speak them aloud. I constantly try to improve my grasp, and it works with me for Hindi, so then I'm sure that it should work with you for English too. In fact, even if I get stuck for a word, I not only look up its meaning, but I also look for synonyms. And this is something that you definitely should do in English. Take for example, the word complicated. Once you know what it means, you should then also know what other words you can use in its place. And hey, the internet is always there to help. You just need to look. Now here is where the hard work increases. I'm sorry, I told you that it was not going to be easy. But ask anyone who is trying to lose weight. Bahut ghisai karna padta hai, boss. If you can't challenge yourself more and start thinking in English in your daily life, then change the language on your phone. Initially, I'm sure it will be very annoying, but it will get to a space of comfort after some time. My name is Freesia, this is WAC, and I'll catch you guys again very, very soon. Ciao! Ajao, Kavita!
If you like this video, hit the bell icon and subscribe.